I don't know about you, but I sometimes get really, really sick of pie. So last week I enlisted the help of some friends at the Taekwondo club where I train to help me with some anger management. Have a look. Okay, so that was fun. I'm now working on an extended version in which we'll kill 70,000 digits. And so the way we do it is we videotape one kick per digit, so from 0 to 9, so 10 different kicks. And what I'll do is I'll write a program that sticks these film segments together in the right order, you know, 70,000 or 100,000 of them. And then I'll have a video that I'll use every time, you know, they'll calculate another trillion digits of pi, or somebody recites like 100,000 digits of pi from memory, and some fool claims that this is somehow mathematically significant, which it isn't. It's completely pointless as far as mathematics is concerned. It's a lot of fun, but it's pointless. Of course, since pi is an irrational number, it has an infinite non-repeating tail of decimals. So no matter how many decimals I kill, there will always be infinitely more to kill. So, I mean, pi is immortal, so this is really quite innocent what I'm doing here. I'm not really killing anybody. Still, it's a lot of fun, and you know, it really helps me overcome this anger. All right. Now, I actually learned something in this whole thing that I didn't know before. So zero appears in pi for the first time as the 33rd decimal. Pretty good. People already knew about the first 33 decimals in 1600. So, and as far as I'm concerned, we could really have stopped calculating at that point in time. You know, 33 digits, oh, let's just go, maybe go up to 100 digits, but after that, it's enough. Seriously, what are all the digits of pi good for? Well, some people have suggested we should use them to communicate with aliens.
You broadcast 31415, and if they understand, they continue the equation.
Right.
Where'd you get that idea, son?
Biting into this.
Okay, so you probably know what I think about this idea and what my three-legged alien friend here thinks about this idea, but I'd be interested in what you think about the idea of communicating with aliens using the decimal expansion of pi. Everybody claims they really care about those digits, but seriously, nobody does. And here's proof. That's the opening sequence of the movie Pi. It's all about pi. It's a movie called Pi. Well, did you notice anything? Well, if you have a really, really close look, there's thousands here, and there's many more thousands coming up. It's only really accurate up to this point. The rest is just made up. Somebody just sat there at a typewriter and typed wildly. Now, here is just a screenshot from Never Been Kissed. It's the mathletes celebrating Pi Day. What can I say? Here's one that's very, very famous. It's the life of Pi. And I'm just going to play this scene, and you see whether you can spot the mistake, okay?
Right. He's really doing this.
By the end of that day, I was Pi Patel, school legend.
So did you spot the mistake? No? Well, it was pretty obvious. So this is the last thing we see here. There's like obviously thousands of digits of pi on the blackboards here. And the last one he writes are 985243744170. And that's definitely in pi. And we can actually look it up where it occurs for the first time. So there's a really nifty tool on the web, which is the pi search page. And you just type in a string of numbers, and it tells you the first time it comes up, if it knows it. So just type in the last 544170. And it tells us that it occurs as the an 87th digit after the decimal point. Okay, so you know he's definitely memorized this thing very well. Pi Patel, the main character of the movie. However, when you have a look at the book that the teacher holds and confirms that everything's correct, it's all in French. So if you have a really, really close look, it says there that what he's looking at is a table of the digits of pi up to the 2000th digit. Now, what a mistake, and you didn't spot it. Anyway, this pi search page is actually a good one to remember next time you want to, you know, count the number of digits on your t-shirt, because the best way to do this is actually just kind of take the last couple of digits. In this case, it's 9999999, six nines. Type them into the search engine and ask, when does this show up? Now, is this a joke, 9999999? And that brings us to the main use of the digits of pi, which is pi t-shirts. But actually, when I think about it, I've got a lot of pi t-shirts, and the best ones actually don't have anything to do with the digits of pi. Have a look. After all this pi, I'm ready to kill a couple more digits, but this time I'm going to do it in style with my brand new pi black belt. Have a look at this, marvelous. 3 meters and 14 centimeters exactly. Lots and lots of digits of pi, of course. How many digits do you think are on this black belt? And how many times do you think this black belt fits around me? Leave a guess in the comments, and happy Pi Day. And thank you very much for 50,000 subscribers.